Where is the kingdom in the sky? This time, our journey takes us to the south of Africa, to the largest country in the world whose entire territory is surrounded by another country. Today, we talk about the kingdom of Lesotho, or more precisely, about football in Lesotho. I said it before. Lesotho is located in the south of Africa, completely surrounded by South Africa. In terms of size, it's comparable to Belgium, and even the so-called lowlands are up to 1,700 meters above sea level. Welcome to the kingdom in the sky. Lesotho has 2.1 million inhabitants, and the head of state is King Letsi III. The capital is Maseru. Football is by far the most popular sport in the country. One more reason to take a closer look at it. The domestic league and the national team are organized by the Lesotho Football Association. The association was founded in 1932 when Lesotho was still the British colony Basutoland. Of course, the association was founded under a different name. The association then became a member of the FIFA and the African Football Confederation CAF in 1964. A little later, in 1970, the Lesotho Premier League was founded, which is still the highest division today. Below that, there are other leagues, the A League, the B League and the C League. We talked to Thabang Malane, Lesotho's national player, about the level of the league. Malane, 24, has been playing for LCS in the Premier League since 2017.
Here in Lesotho, we are not professionals. We are semi-professionals or amateurs.
So, the footballers there are not fully professionals. Perhaps one reason why success in continental club tournaments has been manageable so far. The most successful club at national level is capital team Matlama FC with 10 titles. However, even this team did not make it beyond the preliminary round of the CAF Champions League. Probably the biggest event was in 1997 when Orlando Pirates played Roma Rovers, a Premier League club, in the first round and could not go beyond a 0-0 draw in Lesotho. No Lesotho team took part in the Champions League qualifiers this year, the reason being Corona. Record champions Matlama play their home games at a historic venue, Pitsu Ground, where Lesotho's independence was won. There are currently 16 teams in the Lesotho Premier League. And the mood is the round-robin system, familiar from the major European leagues. Everyone plays each other twice and in the end, the team with the most points becomes champion. Let's move on to the national team, which is currently ranked 144th in the FIFA World Ranking. If you look at the Africa Cup and World Cup statistics, you quickly realize that the team has never been able to qualify. I asked Thabang how the country could fulfill its undoubted potential.
I think we are still behind because we don't have too many players abroad that can bring us experience.
Experience abroad in more professional structures can be a key. Many players are desperate to go down this route, but by doing so, many players also face a big problem.
Most of our players don't have agents, so it is not easy to be transferred from our country to South Africa.
Some have made it to neighboring South Africa. Plus, there's a striker, Tabiso Brown, who is currently playing in Bolivia. Lesotho's first international match was against Malawi in 1970, and their highest win was a 5-0 against Eswatini in 2006. The national team's nickname is Likuena, which means crocodile in the local language Sisotho. In 2004, the association planned a major upswing that would culminate in the qualification for the 2010 World Cup in neighboring South Africa. German coach Antoine Hey was hired for that purpose, but he failed the mission and had to re-sign in 2006. The national team's greatest success thus remained reaching the final of the Kusava Cup in 2000. The Kusava Cup is an annual tournament in which national teams from Southern Africa compete. The current champion is South Africa, with Zimbabwe having the most titles. If you want to see a video just about the Kusava Cup or other local tournaments, write it down in the comments. Thabang still believes in his country's potential and that they will eventually qualify for a major tournament.
I think we can still qualify for the AFCON Cup because here we have many skillful players, very talented players, but we have to work very hard.
He has no small goals for his personal future either. He wants to improve football in his home country and make the leap abroad.
One day, I play outside my country so that I can bring the experience that we need here to qualify for major tournaments.
I wish Tabang all the best for this endeavor and thank him for the exciting insights into the kingdom in the sky. I hope you enjoyed the video. Feel free to subscribe to my channel Football Worldwide. Together, we travel through the world and learn about football in every country in the world. Which nation should I present next? Write it down in the comments and also don't forget to follow my Instagram page, which is also down in the description. I'll say goodbye in the national language Sesotho this time too. Salahankle.